Hey there, pen friends, welcome to the channel again. It's your host Amy from PenVenture, and I'm here with another video regarding tips for FunPen users. No, we are not going to brew some tea because I have here boiling water and also my motivational mug, Love Your Life, and a Nib logo. We are going to tackle heat setting your ebonite feed. I know, for many this may sound something that is very elaborate and complicated, but it's very simple. If you follow a few rules, you can actually improve the ink flow of your ebonite feed. Okay, ebonite feed. Ebonite is hardened rubber. If the feed of your fountain pen is made out of ebonite and your pen is having flow issues, this can improve the ink flow and resolve your problem. Well, let me explain. The feed must be in full contact with the nib in order to have a good ink flow. If the feed has parts that are not touching the nib, that may result in an ink flow issue. How can we resolve that? Well, we are going to heat set the ebonite feed of my 1930 Extra. Although it doesn't need heat setting, we're going to do it. I have here boiling water, and I'm going to put some boiling water inside my cup. Heat setting your ebonite feed will work no matter what cup you're using. I'm using mine. Now I will show you how to do it. You're going to submerge the nib and feed into the boiling water 1 or 2 millimeters above the section, and you're going to wait for 30 to 35 seconds until the feed, which is made out of ebonite, will become a bit more pliable. This way you could make some small adjustments using pressure, and this will resolve the issue of the gap in between the nib and the feed. This way you will improve the ink flow of your pen if that space is present, and that is the problem of your ink flow. If everything else is working, for example, the feed is not clogged up and everything works, but you still have ink flow problems, that may be the issue. Fast forward, 30 seconds just passed. Now we are going to remove the pen out of the water, and we are going to squeeze the nib and feed for 20 seconds or so. We are going to keep them gripped like this, and we are going to wait until the ebonite has cooled off and the new shape is set. If I look closer, I see that the feed is touching the nib and there is no space in between them. So I really think this will improve the ink flow of my funnel pen. Remember, proceed at your own risk. If you have expensive pens, if you're not experienced enough to try this on your ebonite feed, please don't, because you can damage your pen and I will not be responsible for that. But if you're committed and you think you can do it, this is how to do it safely. Well, I think this is it. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you find it useful. If you did so, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to the PenVenture YouTube channel and help us do quality content just like this. My name is Amy, and I look forward to seeing you next video.